Okay, this is unit number one of your grade 11 English pupil book. We have come to activity one. Now in your pupil book, you learnt what are the punctuation marks you need to use in different type of sentences. For statements and commands, you end with a full stop. And for questions, you end with a question mark. For exclamatory sentences, you end with an exclamation mark. Apart from that, you use commas to separate items in a list, or before a question tag, before a subordinative, independent clause. Now, in a sentence, if you have an independent clause and a subordinative clause, and the subordinative clause comes before the independent clause, excuse me, you use a comma. I will teach you that part later when we come to that lesson. So here they have given you a dialogue. You need to use punctuation marks and capital letters where necessary. Let's start writing. Excuse me. Okay. Please tell me, how should I correct this sentence? Yes, Pute? Please tell me, how should I do this one? Yes. E is capital in excuse me, like that you can tell.
Good afternoon. Can you help me to find information for the debate?
No, Pute. This is the workbook. Here. Excuse me, is there a supermarket nearby? Now we are going to put the punctuation marks here. Now we did activity 1 and 2 regarding the punctuations here. Now we are going to the workbook.
Okay.
How should I correct this sentence? After excuse me, what should I do?
E capital.
E capital.
And there's a comma after me.
Okay, we'll put a comma here. And then I will write, is there a supermarket nearby? Now what should I put?
Question mark.
Yes, very good. It's a question. Now next one. How should I write this one?
Yes, Y capital.
Uh-huh.
Yes, there's one close by, then full stop.
Okay, there should be another two punctuation marks in the middle. What are those? After yes, what should you put?
Comma.
Uh-huh, very good. There's one close by. What should I put here? It's a contraction.
After the E apostrophe.
Very good. Close by, no period. How should I correct this sentence?
H capital, mm-hmm. I capital, and how do I get there? Question mark.
Very good. Now you have a little bit of a longer sentence next. Please tell me, how should I correct?
At A capital.
Mm-hmm.
At the traffic lights, comma.
At the traffic lights. Okay, comma.
Take the first left turn and go straight, full stop.
Very good. Why did I put this comma here? Because this is a conjunction that I told you about, independent clause, dependent clause. Now when you say take the first turn and go straight, this one is independent. you don't need any other word to complete this one. When you say take the first turn and go straight, we completely understand. But when you say at the traffic lights, now this one seems a little bit incomplete. Especially, I will give you another example. Jane did not go to school. One sentence. Jane did not go to school. This is an independent clause. It's a sentence itself. Jane did not go to school. When someone says this, we can perfectly understand what it means. Now I'm going to add an dependent clause. Because of the heavy rain, Jane did not go to school. Now, when you think about this part, because of the heavy rain. Now, if you just tell this part and this part is not there, just imagine this part is not there. Now, you don't understand this one. This is not independent. Independent means you can stand alone. But this particular clause cannot stand alone. Why? Because of the heavy rain, it's always a question mark. Yeah, what happened because of the heavy rain? Okay, it doesn't give a complete meaning. So this kind of clauses are called dependent clauses. Why? They depend on another clause to complete their meaning. If you just keep this alone like this, it doesn't make sense. Now we are going to insert an independent clause. Now see if you can understand. Because of the heavy rain, Jane did not go to school. Now this is the independent clause. This is the dependent clause. So when you have this dependent clause before the independent clause, then you must use a comma. What happens if the dependent clause comes after the independent clause? Like this. Jane did not go to school because of the heavy rain. Now, in this case, you do not need to put the comma. Why? Your dependent clause is coming after the independent clause, so it can go as one single unit. Here, this is coming before. The incomplete clause, the dependent clause comes before. So you need to put a comma. Did you understand this, Allah?
Yes.
Yes. Now,
yeah, but I can't see the video.
You can't see the screen? Ayyo, pute.
I write already.
Oh. You should have told me though. Now can you see the file?
Yes. I have written though.
Okay, you have written anyways. I thought I'm showing you this one. See, now this is the dependent clause. This is the independent clause. Now if you have the dependent clause after the independent clause, comma doesn't come. But if you can't see the screen, please tell me. Okay, next one. We have to rewrite this paragraph again in your notebook using correct punctuation marks. How can we do this? Let's start writing. Just take a minute and read this one and mark in your book. Where should be separate sentences? What is one sentence? What are the lists? Where should you use commas? Is there some person talking? So you have to put inverted commas for their words. Like that, please see what is here. Thank you. When you are ready, please tell me. Then we will start.
Okay,
let's start. Please read. Since I don't have a notebook, I'm going to write here. Okay. You can start reading saying this one capital in this and read the sentence and then say full stop. Like that you can go ahead. I will type what you are saying. Okay?
Sum is capital. Some things in life are as rewarding and fulfilling as owning a pet, whether it's a dog, comma, cat, comma, bird or fish, full stop.
Wait, I'm typing yet. I'm still typing. Some things in life are as rewarding and
fulfilling.
As owning a pet. Actually, Gute, you have to stop the sentence here. Owning a pet. Now, some things in life are as rewarding and fulfilling as owning a pet. Right? Next one. What should my next sentence be? Whether.
W capital. It's a dog, comma.
Now, it's a dog. Here, what should I do?
After the S, put apostrophe.
It apostrophe S. Whether it is a dog. Now, see, it is a contraction of it is. So, I have to put it apostrophe S. It's a dog.
Comma.
Now, I'm going to go to the next line. It's a dog, comma, cat,
comma, bird or fish, full stop.
Now what I see, this is the kind of a dependent clause I told you about. Whether it's a dog, cat, bird or fish, what? Like, it's always incomplete. This is not a complete sentence in its old meaning. Whether it's a dog, cat, bird or fish, yes, what happens? Yes? The appeal is the same. Is also coming after this. This is a dependent clause of that sentence. Whether it's like because there's a dog or a bird or a cat like that, it's like incomplete. So you have to put a comma here. Whether it's a dog, comma, cat, comma, bird. Why did we put commas? Here there's a list of animals. Now after the fish, we had to put a comma. Why? Because that is the end of the dependent clause. And the dependent clause has come first in this sentence. The appeal is the same. The appeal is the same. This is the dependent clause. When you say the appeal is the same, we can understand what this means. Right? Let's It's a saying. It is a saying, and then actually full stop. They have explained the situation with a hyphen here. Appeal is the same. What is the appeal? Years of fun and unconditional love. Right? So it's not yet finished. Full stop. Now we have finished that one. Appeal is the same. What is the appeal? Years of fun and unconditional love. Okay. Now where should I start from?
Indeed, pes, I capital.
Mm-hmm. Indeed.
Pes. Indeed, pes can actually satisfy many of the things. Full stop.
Satisfy many of the things, people, what? Crave
most.
Most. What are the things that people crave most?
Companionship.
Yes. Companionship. That is
communication.
Communication.
Loyalty and plenty of amusement.
Amusement. Okay, those are the things that people really love. Crave most means that you are really greedy for. You really need these things, right? Now let's write. Indeed, pets can actually satisfy many of the things people crave most. What are the things that people crave most? Now you are going to explain. So you put a hyphen and write companionship. Now we have a list. So I will put a comma. I will start writing from I will write from here, companionship, comma, space,
communication,
comma, space, loyalty and plenty of amusement. Put a, you also write this one, full stop. Then.
Then perhaps, P capital.
Perhaps.
That's why pets are so popular among the elderly and people who live alone as human relations.
Full stop. Alone. Full stop. Okay. Now there's some contraction here. Perhaps. What is it? What is the contraction after perhaps?
That's.
So how should I write that one?
That's after the T apostrophe.
Very good. That apostrophe S. That's why pets are so popular among whom? The elderly. The elderly and people who live alone. From there, it's finished.
Then, as A capital, as human relationships grow frail with new technological development,
relationships grow frail with new technological development as human relationships grow with new technological development. Now this is an independent clause. As this happens, then what? We don't know. Then you put a comma. Then we see what happens. What happens?
The simple bond between a pet.
Yes.
Between a pet and its owner, offers a refreshing and comforting experience. First.
Pet and its owner. Here, should you put an apostrophe or not? What do you think? Is it a contraction? No. Is it showing the animal's ownership? Is it it is or it's? Namute, what do you think?
It's
like when you say a dog's tail, you write like its tail, like this. You do not put an apostrophe here. If you put an apostrophe, how does it sound like? It is tail. Did you understand?
Yes.
So I'm going to write its here. No apostrophe. Its owner, the simple bond between a pet and its owner, offers a refreshing and comforting experience. Full stop. You also can write in the same place if you have space. Now please finish this and tell me. I will highlight the ones we corrected so it's easier for you to refer. Here S capital, we put a full stop over here. Here W capital, here apostrophe S, comma, 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 hyphen, and full stop. Oops. Full stop. Then we put I capital here, and then okay, then we have a comma over here, full stop here, P capital, apostrophe S here, here full stop, and here A capital, this one comma, and finally we put a full stop. These are the mistakes we corrected.
Finished.
Very good. Now we can move on to the pupil book activity 2. Okay. Yes. Okay, this is the activity 2 of your workbook. Now we have a dialogue here to fill in the blanks with the answers given. Now you have answers like this. Do you like this color or would you like a different color? Do you need anything else, sir? 750 rupees. How about the one next to the black t-shirt? It's very similar to the one you like. Sure, here it is. It's 950 rupees. Okay. Now you please tell me the answers. Good afternoon, sir. May I help you? Good afternoon. Can I see that shirt on the top shelf, please?
Sure, here it is.
Very good. How much does it cost?
It's 950 rupees.
Okay, it apostrophe is 950 rupees. 950 rupees? That's too much.
How about the one next to the black t-shirt? It's very similar to the one you like.
Very good. You can also write with me. That's nice. How much is it?
750 rupees.
Very good. That'll be fine.
Do you like this color or would you like a different color?
That blue one is fine.
Do you need anything else, sir?
Very good. No, that's all I want. Then you can pay at the cashier. Thank you. You're welcome. These are the answers here. Okay. Okay, activity 3. Imagine you are the secretary of the environment society of your school. You have invited the headquarters inspector of the nearest police station to speak about vandalism at your next meeting. Write a notice to inform this to the students. Include the necessary details. Now you have to write, now the notice paper is here. You have to start from here and start writing a notice for the children to inform that this inspector is coming to talk about vandalism. Okay, now we have to just think about how to write this one. You can put a name for this inspector, and you can write on which day at school, which hall, main hall or auditorium or where, which building, and at what time. So just give me a few ideas. Yes. What can we type here?
It is at in the school main hall.
Uh-huh. Who is coming? Mister, you can just put a name. What name can you give this inspector? Okay, I will start writing. We have invited Mr. Who. We'll say Mr. Supul Pereira, comma, who is he? The inspector of the headquarters. Inspector of what is the nearest police, let's say Mull area. We have a police station. To educate our children on what? Vandalism. Okay, vandalism. This meeting will take place on which day? Yes, think and tell me. Let's say 1st of June. Now you have to write ST above in small letters on 1st of June at 9:30 a.m. after the assembly at our school main hall. What is the request for the children? We have to ask them to come and be seated by that time. Okay, so what should we say?
All the
yes, all the students, please be
in time
seated in the main hall before 9:30. Please be seated in the main hall before 9:30 a.m. Now, who's writing this one?
The secretary of the Environment Society.
You have to write the name, right? I will write your name. In your writing, you will have to write your surname as well. Who are you? Secretary. You have to write what association as well. Society. Society. Okay, please copy this notice. You can write this in your own words.
Okay.
Okay.